Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to change the color of your background and your text as you scroll in Elementor. It's a very straightforward process, so sit back, relax, hit that like and subscribe button, and let's get into the video. Okay guys, the first thing you need to do is go to the top left hand side search widget box and type in HTML. Once that widget's displayed, drag it onto your page. It doesn't matter where you put this on your page because you won't see it on the end result, and it only controls the color of your background. What we need to do now is add our HTML code. You can find an exact link to this page with the HTML code in the description below. Now that you're on my page, you're going to need to copy this bit of code. And in the HTML widget code box on the left hand side, you're going to have to paste it in. This is a very simple, straightforward bit of code, and I'm going to go through it now to show you how to change it. In the first line of our code, we set the background color of our page. The first line of our code controls the color of our page load. This is our loading color, and as you can see, it matches the rest of my pages on my website. If your pages are white, you can remove the hex color and type in white. The next thing I'm going to show you on the left hand side is when our color change takes effect. As you can see, mine's set at 150, and this is just under the halfway point of this page. If your page is bigger, you may need to increase this number to make sure it changes at the right point on your page. On the next line down is what we want our page color to change to. Mine's set at white, so once we scroll halfway down our page, it will change from blue to white. And if we go down to the last line of our code, we've got this hex color here. And this is the color that it scrolls back to. So when we scroll upwards, this is the color that's going to be displayed on our page. And as you can see, this matches the color we've got set as our body. So what I'm going to do now is scroll down the page and show you the effect. As you'll see, when we start scrolling down our page, the background color will change. And if we go back up again, it will change back. Like I said earlier on, if we want to change the point at which our color changes, we change this number here. So I'm going to change this to 350. And once we scroll down our page again, more of our page will be blue before it changes to white. And if we use the color changing of our text as a point reference, you can see how much more we've increased it by. If I now change it to 550 and scroll back down our page, you'll see that we scroll down even more to change the color of our background. I'm going to change this back to 150, and we're going to move on to creating the same effect with our text. Now that I've set this back to 150, as we scroll down our page, our text and our background will change at the same time. To create the effect with our text, we're going to need to go back into our Elementor menu. And we do that by clicking on the widget menu icon in the top left hand side and searching in the search widgets box HTML again. Like before, you're going to drag this widget onto the page and you're going to put it where you want to display your text. Now what you're going to need to do is go back over to my website and scroll down to text HTML. And it's this bit of code you need to highlight and copy and paste into the HTML box on the left hand side. Now what I'm going to quickly do is click on our HTML widget and make sure it's this HTML box that we're pasting our code into. Now go back to my website and scroll down to the bottom, and this time you're looking for the CSS code. And it's this little bit of CSS code that's going to let us change the color of our font, the size of it, and the style. And you're going to have to paste this bit of CSS code in the Advanced tab under Custom CSS in the HTML box. I'm going to quickly copy this bit of code now, scroll back up to the top of our page to our HTML widget where we want our text. And as I just said, I'm going to scroll back up to the top of the page and paste it into the Custom CSS box of our HTML widget. Remember, if you do want to use custom CSS within Elementor, you will need Elementor Pro. There is a link for that in the top of the description. And as you scroll past, please do hit that like and subscribe button. So with our CSS code now added, we can start changing it. And the first thing you can change is the color of the text. And this is our starting color for when the page loads. Mine's set as white to contrast the page, so I'm going to now move on to changing the font size. I want it to be noticed on the page, so I'm going to set it to 36. I'm going to change the font style in the next line down to Arial. I want my text to be noticed, so I'm going to leave it as bold, but you can also change its alignment. Mine's set as center, but you can change it to left, center, or right. What I'm going to show you now is the HTML code and show you how to edit it. Now I've made this HTML code exactly the same as the background color change. The only difference being is we're using CSS to change the style of the text. So this part of the code here lets you change how much of the page is scrolled before it changes color. Underneath that is our color we want our text to change to once we scroll past that point. And at the bottom is what we want it to change back to once we scroll up. At the moment, the background color and the text are set at 150. And when we scroll down past that point, you can see both change at the same time. We can change this to 250 and you'll see the background will change first, then the text. And if I show you that quickly now, if I scroll down the page, the background color changes and the text pops in at 250. So you ideally want them both to be set at the same. What I'm going to do now is change that back to 150 and I'm going to click on the preview button in the bottom left hand side next to the publish button. And once our page loads, as we scroll down the page on the right hand side, you'll see our text changes and our background changes at the same time. Remember, you do need Elementor Pro to be able to use custom CSS within Elementor. There is a link for that in the description below. It is an affiliate link, it doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Elementor's profits if you choose to sign up. If you have found this video useful, please do hit that like and subscribe button. And if you've got any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments box below. Don't forget to check out the rest of my videos in the playlist, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.